and welcome to the Morningstar series, Why Should I Invest With You? I'm Emma Wall and I'm joined today by Nicolas Walewski, manager of the Alken European Opportunities Fund. Hello, Nicolas.
Hello, Emma.
So this year has been quite a challenging year for Europe and indeed for your fund. Incredible year last year, but this year performance has been a bit flat. What are the challenges that have held you back?
Yeah, I think this year we had a couple of stocks at the beginning of the year that didn't perform. Thank God we sold them very quickly, but still that hurt us in January and February. Glencore, which is in trouble now, we sold at the beginning of the year. And RWE, which also is in deep trouble. You know, both stocks are have huge financial difficulties. That was at the beginning of the year. And then later on in Q2, we have a couple of tech names, ASML, Micron, Seagate and Western Digital in particular. And these four stocks have been hurt by some weakness in demand for the technological products, and that has hurt us. We see actually a more balanced supply and demand since mid-August.
And fans of the fund, investors in the fund, will know actually that this sort of volatility is part of the nature of your investment style. You do take very punchy bets. So with that in mind, do you expect it to uptick again soon?
Yeah, we hope so. We think there is a lot of value in the market. We think there is a lot of value in the fund. We are very excited, actually, by this correction, and we think it creates plenty of upside for the future.
Thinking of those punchy bets, in 2013, you decided not to expose yourself to stocks that had emerging market revenues, and that paid off well. Obviously, now we're having ever more emerging market volatility. Have you decided to keep that? I mean, have you been hurt by the what's happened in China?
I mean, we've been hurt a little bit this summer through our auto stocks. We were not in the German manufacturers, so we thought we were more or less isolated, but still our French auto stocks suffered somewhat. But apart from that, we were largely out of emerging markets, I mean, China, Brazil, and others, and we viewed that correctly. We think it's still too early in general to be in countries, you know, exposed to countries like Brazil or, you know, Russia, South Africa, and so on. And even on China, we would stay relatively cautious so far.
And what would have to happen for you to change your mind?
Good question. I mean, there could be many things, but we would need to see a more sustainable growth rate in China, which we see is not the case yet, or a change in political leadership in Brazil, which is not the case yet, you know, things like that. And all these triggers, we don't see them yet.
And so they are the things that you're avoiding. What about the places that you are seeing opportunities? What's making you smile at the moment?
Well, Europe. Europe is a good place to be. As you know, we have seen Europe out of sync with the rest of the world for many years. The credit cycle was booming in most places, but not in Europe. We had austerity measures. We had the sovereign crisis in 2011, which led to a very low, a very negative credit cycle. The banks were asked for more capital, for hundreds of billions of more capital. And now, this credit cycle is turning up. The commodity price correction, which is very strong, is fantastic for Europe. And so very, very, very positive on European demand.
Nicolas, thank you very much.
Thank you, Emma.
This is Emma Wall from Morningstar. Thank you for watching.